Today I am super excited because we have the best builder-based player in the world with us. Yuren Trouble is an absolute maniac when it comes to attacking. Last season, he finished number one in the world with over 250 trophies to spare, which I actually kind of take some credit for because in addition to being a crazy attacker, he is a genius when it comes to trapping bases, which caused me to fail on him over 8 times. And I managed to let him agree to let me share some of his live attacks so we can see what makes him the best player in the world. Alright, it's time to go. He uses his battle copter really close. I can only guess to quickly get those air defense. Look at that. He knew exactly where to place it to get it in range of the air defenses, and he's going to immediately take him down. So with that out of the way, there's not much left for this battle copter to worry about. I mean, that archer tower is, but he puts it... But look at this. He puts the baby dragon in range of the air defense so quickly to make sure it's tanking for the battle machine. And now he doesn't have much left. He's using his abilities very quickly here. And look at that. This whole base is already taken down with a whole baby dragon to spare. I mean, it looked a little iffy for a minute there, but it just, he's so quick with his baby dragons and gets so much value with them, it didn't even matter. So let's just go see how he's going to take on this next stage. I mean, he has 3 baby dragons, 2 at full health left to use. That's absolutely insane. He's going to absolutely shred this next part. Wow. This is a hard base. Look at how much he has to deal with here. He has a Mega Tesla, the Air Bombs, a Ground Expo, a Roaster. This is a really difficult base. You don't usually see the second stage so hard. So how is he going to counter it? Let's go find out. He's taking on 3 cannon carts yet again. Very interesting approach by him. I'm super excited to see what he does with them. Now, I don't know where he's going to put him. You see, this Ground Expo is going to knock off a lot of value, as is this Mortar. This is really good base building, so let's see if the number one player in the world can handle that. Starting all his cannons in various different places, all the way down here right next to the Mortar, and those are going to barely outrange it and allow him to get down those air bombs. What a smart play by him. He's going to take out this Roaster too. This is what I mean when I tell you he dissects bases. He's looking at all the vulnerabilities in the base and just absolutely taking him out. Looks like he just dodged a push trap too that is so big. So he has his Mortar barely on the edge of this Ground Expo. How good is he to know when he needs to stop moving it? Because if he moved it maybe even a second longer, it would be in range and it would be useless. So it looks like he's going to be able to take out the Mega Tesla, the Air Bombs, and the Roaster. And he moves his cannon a little too close. Oh, that's a bummer for sure. Now he just needs to make sure he can get this cannon to take out the Mega Tesla though, because he can still take this back. I mean, look at this. This is hardly at health. He has his other cannon taking out an air defense. And now, what does he have to worry about other than this one air defense and this one bomb? This Tesla is down. This is looking absolutely destroyed here. He still has 2 cannon carts and 2 undeployed baby dragons. I mean, look how good he is at this. He's using this cannon cart right now because it is tanked by the builder machine. He's taking out the air bombs, and it looks like he's going to be able to swag 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 troops along with his builder machine. What a smart approach on a base that is super difficult. I can't believe he was able to do it so easily too. And he's still swagging 4 troops, and I'm sure he's not super happy with the attack, just because that is how good he is. Swagging 4 troops is not enough for him. No, look at this. In chat, he just swagged 4 troops on a super difficult base and says, sorry, he's playing a bit bad right now. This just shows how good he is, man. These huge swags are not enough for him. And look at this. He's into another attack here, and he is against a pretty popular base. It's a very scary base too, so what is he going to use against this? Right now he has 6 cannon carts selected. 6 cannon carts? Okay, he's switching to an archer, but still 5 cannon carts, and he's going with it. He's using 5 cannon carts against this guy. This is what makes him so unbelievably good, is that he's able to use such weird troop combinations. And I don't know how he's going to pull this off, but something tells me he has this in the bag. So let's just go see. What does he do? He still has 1 cannon cart left to deploy, and he has an archer tower, another one, a multi-mortar, and another archer tower. So this base is pretty well defended against cannon carts. I do not know why he's going against it with 5 of them, but I'm going to trust him. He knows what he's doing. I'm sure of it, so let's just go see where he goes from here. He has 4 archers left to deploy. This Kanakart just soloed the whole archer tower. The builder machine's tanking the other one. There's actually not that much left for this base. And he's using the archers, I'm guessing, to take out the archer tower. How genius is that? And a Tesla pops up. Look at that. He just found a lot of traps. But I think he's okay. So he's going to put both cannon carts down here to take out this giant cannon. And look at that. They get it down. He still has this one all the way up. And now nothing can actually hit these cannon carts. Did he lose a single cannon cart? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cannon carts left. He kept every one of them alive. What are you going to do against him? How are you going to defend this? How are you going to defend someone who's using the most crazy strategies to take down your base? This is absolutely unbelievable to watch. Look at that, and there it goes. So now he's going on to the second stage of this base with 5 cannon carts still surviving. And he has 7 cannon carts selected, I imagine. He's using 7 cannon carts on the second stage. He finds Teslas. He finds every Tesla, it looks like, and he just puts down 4 cannon carts back to back. This base is about to get destroyed by cannon carts. He still has 1 left to deploy. Where is he going to use it? He finds some traps down here. That is really unfortunate. It looks like this guy is trapping against cannon carts for some reason. So he has 1 cannon cart left to deploy. And what does he want to do with it here? He still has so many working. It looks like he's going to accidentally get in range of a cannon. And he takes it out in time. He still has every single one of his cannon carts alive. He is so smart. Is he going to get this down though? I think he's going to swag 7 cannon carts here. Maybe 6. He just got sniped by the cannon. But is that really even that big a deal? He used all cannon carts. And he's swagging almost every single one of them. This is so crazy to watch, man. He's truly the best in the world. He's into another attack. And he's going against a pretty popular base. I haven't seen this one today by him, though. So what is he going to use against it? 3 Super P.E.K.K.A.s, 2 cannon carts, and a bomber. This is a pretty anti-P.E.K.K.A. base. Oh, he just got baited. That's not good. What is he going to do here? So I imagine there's probably some more bait up there for him. Is he still going to be able to pull this off even though he just lost his whole cannon cart to some bombs? Something says yes to me, and I'm ready to see how. Now he knows exactly how much health this cannon cart has, because you see, he is letting it solo this archer tower with no worry here. He just knows the interaction so well, immediately puts it onto the mortar mode, and he's going to take out the double cannon, the Mega Tesla. He's using his battle copter to take out this double cannon down here, and then all he has left is these 2 crushers and this double cannon. This base looks crushed, guys, honestly. Oh, this barbarian is going to cause him some trouble. Is he going to be able to take it down in time? Yes, he is. And now he can get in range of the Mega Tesla. And he has this whole P.E.K.K.A. up here to spare. He uses the bomber up here. So get him into this whole rest of the base. And this looks really strong right now. And he's going to use the ability to splash onto the archer tower. How smart is that? So he has to worry about these crushers now. Oh, he takes out the archer tower with the battle machine ability. Now what is there left to even stop him here? Immediately gets down those crushers. He gets down the roaster. And now he just needs to take down that last crusher. And he has 3 P.E.K.K.A.s to spare. Oh no. Oh, I thought there was a troll Tesla. He just has this army camp to get to. Hopefully there's no bombs to kill the P.E.K.K.A.s. Nice. So he's swagging 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 troops on the first stage. The only troop he lost was because he got baited. That's it. And he's getting another cannon cart and another P.E.K.K.A. And he has his ground battle machine. Let's see what he does against this. Looks like he's going for both these cannons down here. And he's out of range of this one by a little bit, and he knows it. So he's gonna just keep it into the cannon mode until he takes down that building. Now, what does he do from here? Looks like he has his cannon cart barely outranged the cannon. Look at how close he is. But he knows so well just when to stop them. And he still has four P.E.K.K.A.s and a battle machine. Guys, this is gonna be so hard. Not hard, this is gonna be so crushed, sorry. And let's just see what he does. He's taking down both the cannons, and then if he tanks for the giant cannon with a P.E.K.K.A., he can take it out with his cannon cart. So he's gonna take out this corner hut first, just to make sure he doesn't have a time fail. And then where does he go with the rest of his troops here? Let's see, I'm imagining from up here, he's doing exactly what I said. He's tanking for this giant cannon with his cannon cart, and he's gonna take it down from behind the wall. He triggers a Tesla, both the Teslas, and then he uses the last two Super P.E.K.K.A.s at the very top. Guys, this base is so far gone, it's not even funny. He just crushes everyone in his path. And this is not easy bases. This is in the top 10 of the world, and he's swagging three P.E.K.K.A.s, two cannon carts, a bomber, and his battle machine. Okay, this is a little bit after the recording, but Yearn just shared this replay to me, and it's absolutely insane. You guys gotta see this. This isn't any easy base either. This is the base that Bird made himself, which is now used worldwide. Clash Bashing even featured it in his video. This isn't an easy base. Let's just go see what he does against it. So he puts his first cannon cart right here, out of the range of everything. And from here, he can reach the roaster, the double cannon, and the crusher, which is exactly what he does. So watch this. He's going to go ahead and wipe out all the buildings, and then he's going to put it into the mortar mode. Now down here, he already has yet another mortar starting, which can also reach the double cannon. So just let's see this whole thing unfold. He puts down his battlecopter up here to get rid of this double cannon and this archer tower and even the crusher if the mortar up here couldn't get to it. And he just lets them do their thing for a little bit. So you see up there, one double cannon's down. He has another mortar down there about to get the second double cannon. And the crusher is going down to the battlecopter, and now he's taking down the roaster too. And look at this, he's in range of this other double cannon. So already, all three double cannons are pretty much gone, and so is his roaster. And you look at the base, what's left? An archer tower, a mega Tesla, a lava launcher, a crusher, and an archer tower. That's it. That's all he has to deal with from now. So he's going to keep going through this now. And really soon here, once his double cannon's down, he's going to deploy his P.E.K.K.A.s, and they're going to absolutely rip through this base. I mean, from this point on, there is almost nothing that can stop him, so he's just going to let him go crazy. They have to deal with the guard post units. He even uses the builder machine ability to go try and take down the mega Tesla. He missed his P.E.K.K.A. abilities, but at this point it doesn't matter. Now look at this bomber usage. The walls were already open up here, so he didn't use it up there. Instead, he used it on the P.E.K.K.A. from the outside to let it get all the way into the core and go for this crusher. And that's exactly what happens. So the archer tower is being tanked. He lets his cannon cart go into it. And then now there's just one crusher, and he has three P.E.K.K.A.s on it. He doesn't even need to worry about it. And then when you look at it, he has one cannon cart, another cannon cart, a bomber, and three P.E.K.K.A.s. His whole army is still alive here. He didn't lose a single troop in the first stage, and they're all pretty healthy. So heading to this next stage, he's going to switch out the archers for all P.E.K.K.A.s, and he's just going to start his cannons working around the corners again. Right here, he can access this cannon, this air defenseman. Over here, he's going to be able to access this cannon down there. So he's just letting them work, giving them their time that they need. That's what he told me when I was asking him. He says the number one thing is patience, because they need to have their time to go thin out the base for you. Now he starts out the battle machine all the way in the corner, finds a Tesla, or two actually, but it doesn't matter. Look, he's now placed on all his P.E.K.K.A.s, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and he has one more left in the pocket. What's going to take them down? There's one cannon, one mortar, one Tesla, and one giant cannon. He has nothing to worry about, so they just rip through this base. And we'll put it in normal speed now, because it's not that much longer. He has his battle machine nearly at full health. He still has every single troop. Not a single troop died in this entire raid, in none of the stages. He swagged the whole army. He didn't need any of it. And he just takes Bird down easily with all his troops still alive. This just shows how strong a strategy can be when it's in the hands of the best player in the world.